to everyone watching and welcome back to my channel. My name is Terry and this is another video continuing my Eurovision 2024 national final selection reactions. And in this video I'm reacting to the six songs taking part in the Irish national selection Eurosong. Now all songs have been announced throughout the week on Irish radio and you're going to check out all the songs now and give you my opinions on them. But before we get into that, I hope you do like this video, and if you do, please click the like button, as it helps a lot with the algorithm. Also, please consider subscribing and hit the notification bell to be informed when all future Eurovision 2024 videos are released. Please do let me know in the comments down below what your thoughts are on the six songs taking part in Eurosong. Who are your favourites? Who are you wanting to win? Who do you want to see go through represent Ireland in Malmo? And also, if you want to follow me on Instagram, you can do. Details are on screen in the description box, beginning and end of the videos. And yeah, on there I post like my Eurovision upload schedules and other stuff there too. So please feel free to do that. But without further ado, let's begin with the reactions. Okay, so before we actually get into it, I do have to say that I have heard three of the songs before. I was doing reactions as they were filled as the week was going on. But what I realised very quickly was that the songs uploaded to YouTube were just lifted straight from the radio recording. So recorded straight off the radio, so you wasn't getting a great quality of them. I noticed a couple of them were being cut short as well. And yeah, so for that reason I decided to wait for all the songs throughout, and hopefully we get proper sort of audio and proper quality of all the songs. So that's why I've done that. I have heard this first song, Ailsha with Go Tobann, already. The very first time I heard it, I did think it was very interesting and very noisy, and I couldn't really get into it properly because the quality wasn't very good from the version that we were hearing from the radio. But let's listen to the live version that we've got here and see what we think of it. Yes, we're getting a bit of a stronger quality and sound coming through. Still quite difficult to make out some of what she's singing, which I did have the issue with on the radio rip that I heard. And this bit here is quite noisy. And it does sort of sound like a Celtic vibe, but kind of on speed, if that makes sense. But this is definitely a stronger quality audio than what we was getting from the radio. And now that I'm able to sort of hear it a bit better, I'm kind of getting into it a bit more. And I really do appreciate that we're getting the Irish Celtic language there. But yeah, what I am noticing it more is, even in this version, I'm not really hearing the vocals very much at all. It's just really just the music, the instrumentation that you're hearing. But it has got quite an infectious beat there. But I am really looking forward to seeing how this can be performed live, because it is quite a song that's going to rely on being performed well with good staging and everything. And Ireland do really need to go for something different to make them stand out after so many missed finals. And maybe this could be the one that they should go for. It is definitely very crazy, and I think a lot of people will find it just noise. That's what I did think on my very original listen to this. Next up, I'm going to listen to Bambi Thug, and it's on Doomsday Blue. Now, I've not actually heard this one yet at all, but I have heard quite a few people talking about it, so quite interested to see what it sounds like. I do know from what people have said, it is sort of another song similar to Ailsha that would be quite different for Ireland to go with. Quite difficult to make out vocals here too. Thank you. definitely an interesting start there. Wasn't really able to get into that stuff, but not really sure what to say of this one. I think again, similar to Ailsha, I would have to listen to see this performed live to make my mind up on it. It's just that the those kind of rocky, electro, whatever you want to call their moments, mixed in with this very mellow vibe, are two very different vibes that they're going for. This bit is quite nice, but I'm not sure if I'm really feeling the other part at all. This bit here, I quite like this kind of mystical, dark vibe that's going on there. And I think if done staging well, maybe this section here, it could create a bit of a moment. But otherwise, similar to how I felt when I first heard Go Tobann first time, I feel with this one as well. The whole thing sounds like kind of messy and noisy, just to me. I definitely do feel similar to that one. I do need to see this performed live in perhaps a better quality version as well. Number three for me to check out is Erica Cody and Love Me Like I Do. This is one of the ones that I heard earlier in the week. So let's see what I think of it on second listen. Yeah, so this one has definitely a more mainstream vibe than the previous two. It's got that kind of more traditional female up-tempo pop dance vibe going on there. The production is a lot cleaner in this one than the other two as well. I do like the vibe of the song. It's got a good sort of feel-good vibe, but from my memory, I feel like I felt that the song didn't progress a lot on the first listen. I felt like it kind of stayed a bit on the same level all the way through. Let me see what I'm thinking of it sort of with this listen. Yes, I definitely feel like with this one, I feel like these choruses are just not coming in with a lot of impact. I feel like they're kind of just on the same level as the first is. They're enjoyable, it's radio-friendly, but I'm not sure a lot about this song really makes it stand out amongst the crowd. Yeah, it just feels like the sort of song that you'll hear on the radio. I think, oh, that's quite nice. But then perhaps quickly forget about as well. Yeah, and then this second last chorus that comes in, they've kind of tried to go for a key change that I feel doesn't really work because they're not really committed to a key change a lot. It's just a very half-hearted key change. And then at the same time, quite an obvious way of doing it as well. So after three, it's definitely the one that's most to my style, but by the same token, it's not one that I am particularly crazy about, unfortunately. Now moving onwards with song four from Isabella Kearney with Let Me Be The Fire. This was one of the other ones that I did here on just the radio audio version that was available during the week. I do remember this was kind of more of a general, again, a more of a general female pop style song. I see you in the distance, how you this bit has got a nice vibe to it, a nice beat going on there. I mean, remember in this bit now, I quite like the kind of the modernish vibe going on there with this bit going into in the chorus here. It's got kind of like a cool vibe, which if staged well could come across good. It's just almost like a little bit too chilled and laid back maybe for Eurovision in its vibe. I think, again, I'm thinking, where is the standout amongst this song? And it's not quite giving it. So it would be reliant on the thing that makes it stand out on the staging. But she's got good vocals here. I'm liking her vocally here. And this is where we kind of chilled and mellow. Again, it falls into that perhaps too radio-friendly vibe. So it's interesting, so we've got this and Erica's song that are both very radio friendly and more to my style, but I see that they've not really got a lot that's going to make them stand out. And then you've got the previous two, Ailsha and Bambi Fug, who perhaps not quite so radio friendly, they're definitely not to my style. They definitely to me sound quite messy at times, but they've probably got the more potential to do something for Ireland at Eurovision. We now move on to Jay Yellow, are we pronouncing his name, and Judas. Not heard this one at all yet, but I know we've got kind of a rap style, that's what I've heard from people in terms of this one. Which is not really my genre, if I'm honest. Gets bigger and the lens is what changes. Yeah, that's when your friends become strangers. Read between the lines and then that's why I'm only left with distaste. You give them a peek of how you're working on the big break. Yeah. And they wanna take it, but never know what it takes. I don't get a big place, so I find it very difficult to comment on this type of song because this isn't really my type of music. So I don't really know what's good quality rap and what's not good quality. And it's something that's not really done in Eurovision at all. I'm quite liking this bit here of the female vocal, which is quite nice. The old song's very kind of mellow and chilled, obviously very retrospective. I quite like the melody and the tune going on in the background. That's pretty pleasant. So in terms of rap songs going, although it's not really my style, I'm not fully disliking it. But yeah, again, I'm not sure it's sort of standing out enough, apart from being a rap song, to really attract voters. And you have to wonder how many people that would be into this rap type music would be watching Eurovision to begin with. But it's always good to see different styles. And I think we probably haven't got a full version because this is obviously just cut out early. So difficult for me to give a proper opinion of this at the moment. It's disappointing that Ireland haven't put out all the songs properly. But yeah, that's just my impressions of what I was able to take away from what I heard there. So the sixth and final one I have lined up is next in line with the song Love Like Us. Now I do know that this is a group put together by Louis Walsh, which made a lot of people very apprehensive about it, obviously thinking it's just going to be a very typical boy bandy type thing. I do understand as well that this was put automatically through to the final without having to go through any kind of jury selection process. But let's give it a try and see what we think. I did actually enjoy Ireland's song last year, We Are One. I was one of the few people that did actually quite like it. This is giving a kind of a country vibey feel so far. sort of a nice vibe going on there, a nice anthemic vibe. But I think we've kind of learned now that perhaps this type of thing isn't really the sort of stuff that does well at Eurovision anymore. And I think boy bands in Eurovision haven't had the best history recently. So I think, yeah, very much that the audience isn't quite there so much on them anymore, if there ever has really been that audience in Eurovision before. It's good, but again, I don't feel like it's really standing out a lot. It just sounds very generic-y type thing. But again, I don't think we've got a very good quality audio here to judge a song, similar to most of, if not all of the songs, to be honest, so. Yeah, this whole part is a very kind of generic-y type of thing, especially in these kind of boy band songs. I do have to be honest, I do enjoy this. It is kind of very much in my sort of area of musical likes. But I appreciate there's a lot of people out there that would definitely not want this to represent Ireland, because it is kind of giving what they've given in the past a lot. And I do feel that Ireland probably need to take a bit of a different step in a different direction if they are wanting to get success at Eurovision again. So yeah, those are just my opinions. And yeah, we can see there from the end, this was taken straight from the radio. So that's probably why we wasn't getting a strong quality audio version there. So there we have it. Those are the six songs competing in Eurosong, hoping to represent Ireland. I have to say, it is quite annoying that we haven't been given sort of full, like, official audio versions of all the songs. It seems like a couple of them may have put them out on their own channels, but a lot of it is still just being ripped from the radio, which is obviously not giving the best quality sound-wise. So it's really annoying, and it does kind of show an example of where I don't feel Ireland is taking Eurovision fully seriously at the moment. It's kind of not, yeah, it's not really high on their list of priorities, which is still disappointing to see. I do appreciate that in the songs there is a bit of a mix-up in terms of the genres, and with Ailsha and Bambi Thug, there is something that's definitely a bit different. Personally, I don't necessarily think that there's anything there that really stands out as a definite qualifier. I mean, going with either Ailsha or Bambi Thug would definitely be a risk, but at the moment, just based on the audio versions that were available to me listening to them, they do both kind of sound very messy, and I just worry if that's not corrected or any different when you listen to an actual, like, perfect audio, like a studio version that's like with good quality, whether that will make any difference. And then we've also got to think about what they're going to sound like live. So yeah, I am kind of a bit on the fence in terms of those six songs. I think it's definitely good to see a bit some risks there. There are a few of the traditional sounding stuff, but overall, I'm kind of disappointed, if I'm honest, with that selection, and I'm not sure whether anything would really particularly stand out or enough to go through. Yeah. Not really too sure what to say about that selection. But yeah, that's just my opinions. I can't even really say what I'd want to win. That if I was to pick two, I'd probably lean in more towards Erica Cody or Isabella, because I feel they're both more towards my genre that I like. But I think I appreciate that neither of them will stand out enough, whereas I think Ailsha and Bambi Thug do have the potential to go through, but they're not really to my taste. So that's just what my opinions are. But I'd be interested to know what you think of the selection, so please do let me know your comments down below. If you're from Ireland, I'd be really interested to see what you think of this selection. And do you think you're heading in the right direction in terms of Eurovision with this? Please let me do know that. If you did enjoy this video, please click the like button. If you also enjoyed, you can consider subscribing this notification bell to be informed of all future Eurovision related videos. And also feel free to follow me on Instagram if you want to. And yeah, that's everything. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please do take care. And until the next time, goodbye.